Hello friends, welcome to Electrical Bytes, and in this video we are going to study some of the important MCQs on network theorems, so which are going to help you in the upcoming exams like VSAG, NLCIL, NPCIL or CIL or GATE, ESE or PSUs. So these MCQs will really help you in the upcoming exams. So let us start. So before going to the MCQs, so we need to know some of the basic definitions of the following. So let us see the first one. So what is linear? So what is a linear element? So a linear element is the one in which there is a proportional change in current and voltage. So as the voltage varies, proportionally the current also varies. So the example for the linear element are the resistor, capacitor or inductor. Next is non-linear element. So as I said, the element in which there is not proportional or in the sense there is no relation between the current and voltage, those element we call it as non-linear elements. So the example for the non-linear elements are transformer, amplifiers, logic gates are the examples for non-linear elements. Next is active elements. So what are active elements? So the one which supplies the energy or which doesn't depends on the source are called as active elements. So the examples for the active elements are the ICs, integrated circuits, batteries, amplifiers or logic gates. So these are all the active element examples. Next is the passive elements. So the passive elements are the one which needs the energy from the source, so which depends on source. So the examples for the passive elements are the resistor, capacitor, inductor. So these are the elements which do not supply energy, but for its operation it needs the energy from external source. So such elements we call it as the passive elements. Next is the unilateral elements. So unilateral elements are nothing but in which the current flows in one direction. So such elements we call it as unidirectional. A simple example for unilateral is a diode. In a diode, the current flows in one direction. So as you can see, all semiconductor devices except DIAC are called as the unilateral elements except DIAC. All the semiconductor devices are called as unilateral. Next is bilateral. So the elements in which the current is bidirectional, which means the flow of current is bidirectional. It will flow clockwise as well as the anticlockwise. Such element or such network we call it as bilateral network. The example is a resistor, capacitor or inductor. These are the elements for the bilateral. So for resistor, capacitor, inductance, these are the bilateral elements in which flow of current may be from either positive or in a reverse direction. So these are some of the basic definition that we need to know before going to the theorems or the MCQs of theorems, which will help you to answer the further coming MCQs. So let us start our MCQs. So the first question is, Ohm's law is not applicable in case of. So as you all know that Ohm's law defined as at constant temperature, the current flowing through a circuit is directly proportional to the voltage applied across the network. So this Ohm's law is not applicable for which of the element? So the options are insulator, semiconductors, filament bulb or all of the above. So as we all know, the Ohm's law is also called as the ohmic law or the linear component law, so which is applicable only for linear elements, not for non-linear elements. So option 1, 2, 3 are all the non-linear elements. So all of the above, option 4 is correct. Ohm's law is not applicable for insulators, semiconductors, filament bulbs. So it is only applicable for conductors. So option 4 is correct, all of the above. next question is law of conservation of energy is the other name of. So the options are Faraday's law, Kirchhoff's current law, Kirchhoff's voltage law, or Ohm's law. So the law of conservation of energy is the other name of which of the following? So the correct option is Kirchhoff's voltage law is also called as law of conservation of energy. In a similar way, the Kirchhoff's current law is also called as law of conservation of charges. So you can remember it. So option 3, Kirchhoff's voltage law is correct. Next is the following theorem, which is applicable for more than one sources. So the first one is Thevenin, next is superposition, next is Norton or reciprocity. So when we define the theorems, these theorems says that Thevenin, Norton and reciprocity, it is applicable only for one sources, which means the network need to be have one source. But in case of superposition, it is applicable for more than one source. So the correct option is option 2. Superposition theorem is the theorem which is applicable for more than one sources. So option 2 is correct. Next is Kirchhoff's law are applicable for dash networks. So the options are linear, non-linear, linear and non-linear or none. So the correct option is the Kirchhoff's law, whether it may be a voltage law or a current law, these are applicable for both the linear and non-linear networks. So option 3 is correct. Next is the efficiency at maximum power transfer is. So the options are 25%, 50%, 75% or 100%. So as per the maximum power transfer theorem, so the we all know that whenever the load resistance is equal to the source resistance, then maximum power transfer occurs. So here they are asking the efficiency of the network, efficiency of not power. So the correct option is 50%. So efficiency of a network at maximum power transfer is 50%. Option 2 is correct. Next is, if ZL is the load resistance and ZS is the source resistance, then the efficiency of network can be achieved 100% when? So here they are asking, if ZL is the load resistance and ZS is the source resistance, then efficiency of a network can be achieved 100% in which of the following conditions? So let us see the options one by one. When the load resistance is equal to 0, when source resistance is equal to infinity, when load resistance is equal to infinity or none. So the correct option is, in order to achieve efficiency 100%, the load resistance should be infinity. So option 3 is correct. So in the other case, so if the source resistance is 0, then also the efficiency of a network is achieved 100%. So either of the case, it is correct. So here the load resistance, whenever the load resistance is infinity, then the efficiency can be achieved 100%. So option 3 is correct. Next is, which of following theorem is applicable for linear passive networks? So let us see the options. So first is Thevenin, Norton, superposition or reciprocity. So when you see the definition of all these theorems, the basic definition of all the theorems. So first, Thevenin theorem states that it is applicable for linear active bilateral. Second, Norton, it is also applicable for linear bilateral active network. Superposition theorem, it is also for linear active bilateral. So the option 4, reciprocity, it is applicable for linear bilateral passive network. So the correct option is option 4, reciprocity. So it is applicable for passive networks. The option 1, 2, 3 are only applicable for active networks. So the correct option is option 4. The next question is, equivalent generator theorem is an extension of dash theorem. So the options are superposition theorem, reciprocity theorem, Millman's theorem or Telegen's theorem. So the correct option is, it is the extension of Millivan's theorem. So option 3 is correct. So equivalent generator theorem is also called as Millivan's theorem. Next is, equivalent generator theorem provides a circuit equivalent to. So the options are Thevenin circuit, Norton circuit, Thevenin or Norton, or none. So here they are asking, whenever we apply a equivalent generator theorem, it will result in which of the following network, whether it is a Thevenin or it is a Norton. So the correct option is, it will result in either a Thevenin network, which is a voltage source in series with a resistance, or it will result in a Norton circuit, which is a current source in parallel with a resistance. So option 3, Thevenin or Norton circuit, is correct. Next is the theorem which is applicable for only independent voltage or current sources. So here they are asking the theorem which is applicable only for independent voltage and current sources. So the options are superposition theorem, Thevenin theorem, Kirchhoff's or Millivan's theorem. So the correct option is the Millivan's theorem, option 4. So in Millivan's theorem, it is only applicable for independent sources, not dependent source. So the option 1, 2, 3 are applicable for either dependent or independent sources. So here the option 4 is correct. Next is, as per the maximum power transfer theorem, the maximum power transferred in a network is. So the options are 25% to 50%, 50% to 100%, less than 50%, or always 50%. So as we all know that, as per the maximum power transfer theorem, whenever there is a maximum power transfer, the efficiency in the power transferred is 50% of supplied by the source. So the correct option is, it is always 50%. So it is neither less than 50% nor more than 50%. It is exactly always 50% of the source power. Next, let us see the 12th question. Which of following theorem is also convenient for the network which follows Kirchhoff's law? So the options are Thevenin theorem, Norton theorem, superposition theorem, or Telegen's theorem. So the correct option is Telegen's theorem. So here you can see the relation between the Kirchhoff's law and Telegen's theorem. So it is a theorem which is also convenient for the network which follows Kirchhoff's law. So option 4 is correct. Next is the theorem which is not applicable for both linear and nonlinear circuits. I mean the networks. So the options are the Kirchhoff's law, Telegen's theorem, or the substitution theorem, or superposition theorem. So the correct option is the option 4, superposition theorem. So the next question is, Thevenin and Norton theorems are not applicable for dash networks. The options are unilateral, bilateral, unilateral and bilateral, or none. So the correct option is Thevenin or Norton are not applicable for unilateral networks. So as per the definition of Thevenin and Norton, it is already stated that it is only applicable for bilateral networks. So option 1 is correct. Next is the only theorem which deals with linear or nonlinear, active or passive, time variant or time invariant. So the options are superposition, reciprocity, Millivan's or Telegen's. So the correct option is the theorem which deals with linear or nonlinear, active or passive, time variant and time invariant is Telegen's theorem. It is the only theorem which deals with all the above parameters. So option 4 is correct. Next is, which of following statement is true? Options are Thevenin theorem equivalent to parallel circuit, Norton theorem equivalent to parallel circuit, RC circuit is a dual pair, or RL circuit is a dual pair. So the correct so let us see one by one. So as per Thevenin, it is a equivalent circuit of a voltage source voltage source series with a resistance. So it is not a parallel circuit, Norton theorem. So it is a circuit in which the current source is in parallel with the resistance. So option 2 is correct. So also we need to see third and fourth. So RC circuit is not a dual pair. So dual pair is nothing but whenever there is a exchange in energies of two elements. So those we call it as dual pairs. The example for dual pair is a LC circuit. LC circuit is a dual pair. So here the correct option is option 2. Norton theorem is equivalent to a parallel circuit. Next is, which of the following statement is true? Options are, all linear elements are unilateral, all non-linear elements are unilateral, all linear elements are bilateral, or all non-linear elements are bilateral. So the correct option is all linear elements are bilateral. So the correct option is option 3. Bilateral is nothing but flow of current is in the either directions. Either it may be from clockwise or anti-clockwise, reverse. In both the cases, the flow of current is there. So such element we call it as bilateral elements. Next is, which of following is a pair of duals? So options are resistor inductor, resistor capacitor, capacitor inductor, or none. So the correct option is, as I said, so the conductor, the capacitor and inductor are nothing but the pair of duals. So here whenever it is subjected to a supply, there is the exchange of energies in between the elements. So option 3 is correct. Next is, superposition theorem holds good for dash excitation. So options are AC excitation, DC excitation, AC or DC, or none. So the correct option is option 3, AC or DC. So superposition theorem is applicable for AC excitation as well as DC excitation. Next, choose the correct statement with respect to reciprocity theorem. So let us see the options. It is applicable for linear active networks, not applicable for initial relaxed circuits, applicable for dependent and independent sources, or applicable for circuits with RLC elements. So the correct statement with respect to reciprocity theorem is option 4. It is applicable for the circuit with RLC elements. So option 4 is correct. So here you can also see that it is also applicable for the circuits which are initially relaxed. So option 2, it is also applicable for the initially relaxed circuits. So these are some of the important MCQs of the network theorems. So hope you like the content. You like the content of this video. So thank you for watching. So if you really like the content, so please do like, share and comment below the video. So if you have any doubts, please share in the comment section. And also please subscribe our channel, that is Electrical Bytes, and press the bell icon to get the latest notification about the videos. And also you can join the Telegram channel. The link of the Telegram is given in the description box. So hope you like the video. Thank you.